So when exactly will you get that $1,400 stimulus check? Let's discuss the details in this video. But before we do, don't forget to like this video and subscribe. I'd also like to thank my sponsor, Webull. They've partnered with me to provide free stocks for my viewers, valued up to $1,600. It's completely free and takes 2 minutes. All you need to do is open an account using my link. The link is in the description of this video, just below the like button. Feel free to sell the stocks immediately to use the money if you'd like. Just make sure to open an account and then click on the green button that says get free stocks. Okay, we're going to discuss estimated payment dates for that $1,400 stimulus check. But first, let's watch a quick recap of what Biden had to say this week regarding stimulus.
My fellow Americans, it's been 343 days since the virus that has ravaged our nation tragically claimed its first life. On February the 6th in 2020, Patricia Dowd took her last breath at home under the California sun in Santa Clara. She was 57 years old, a beloved wife, mother, daughter, sister. She never knew she had the virus at the time when most folks never heard about the virus. But just like that, she was gone. And almost exactly 1 year later, nearly 400,000 of our fellow Americans have met the same cruel fate. Countless families and friends left behind with unrelenting grief and guilt, anger and frustration. And the emptiness felt by the loss of life is compounded by the loss of our way of life. During this pandemic, millions of Americans, through no fault of their own, have lost the dignity and respect that comes with a job and a paycheck. Millions of Americans never thought they'd be out of work. Many of them never even envisioned the idea, are facing eviction, waiting for hours in their cars to feed their families as they drive up to a food bank. Millions have kept their jobs but have seen their hours and paychecks reduced, barely hanging on as well. That's happening today in the United States of America. Just as in the midst of the dark winter of this pandemic, as cases, hospitalizations, and deaths spike at record levels, there is real pain overwhelming the real economy. One where people rely on paychecks, not their investments, to pay for their bills and their meals and their children's needs. You won't see this pain if your scorecard is how things are going on Wall Street. But you will see it very clearly if you examine what the twin crises of a pandemic and this sinking economy have laid bare. The growing divide between those few people at the very top who are doing quite well in this economy and the rest of America. Just since this pandemic began, the wealth of the top 1% of the nation has grown roughly $1.5 trillion since the end of last year, four times the amount for the entire bottom 50% of American wage earners. Some 18 million Americans are still relying on unemployment insurance. Some 400,000 small businesses have permanently closed their doors. And it's not hard to see that we're in the middle of the once-in-several-generations economic crisis with the once-in-several-generations public health crisis. The crisis of deep human suffering is in plain sight, and there's no time to waste. We have to act, and we have to act now. This is what economists are telling us. More importantly, it's what the values we hold dear in our hearts as Americans are telling us. A growing chorus of top economists agree that the moment of crisis, in this moment of crisis, with interest rates at historic lows, we cannot afford inaction. It's not just that smart fiscal investments, including deficit spending, are more urgent than ever. is that the return on these investments in jobs, racial equity, will prevent long-term economic damage, and the benefits will far surpass the cost. A growing number of top economists has shown even our debt situation will be more stable, not less stable, if we seize this moment with vision and purpose. And so tonight, I'd like to talk to you about our way forward, a two-step plan of rescue and recovery.
Okay, it's really clear that Biden's number one priority is to get this stimulus package approved and approved quickly. Now let's recap exactly what's included. First of all, I want to point out the fact that Biden did not include that $200 per month stimulus boost for those on Social Security, but he has promised us to get that done within the first 100 days. So we do expect a lot of updates on that as well. Now, as far as this current stimulus package, he is expected to include those $1,400 stimulus checks, of course, including adult dependents, a large group of people who were previously excluded, another unemployment boost of $400 per week expected to last until the end of September, as well as extending the eviction and foreclosure moratorium until the end of September as well. Now, despite the fact that Biden wants to have this approved quickly, there are concerns that it might be delayed. And best case scenario here, we'll have the stimulus approved in about 3 weeks. Worst case scenario, it's going to be about 3 months. Now, I'll walk you through exactly why. First of all, Biden is trying to operate in a bipartisan fashion. Now, just to clarify, Republicans cannot block this stimulus. One way or another, Democrats will get this massive stimulus package approved. But if Democrats can get Republican support, this package can be approved as quickly as 3 weeks. If they don't get Republican support, it will take 3 months because Democrats will have to use something called budget reconciliation. Now, I won't go too deep into that, but that is a loophole that both Democrats and Republicans use every year. Trump used it to approve tax cuts, and Obama used it to approve Obamacare. But let's back up a little bit here, because even if Biden gets Republican support, he is worried that the impeachment trial in the Senate will slow down this stimulus. And it's true. Now, even if Republicans are fully on board with this package in a best case scenario, it's going to take about 3 weeks, give or take, to get this stimulus package approved because one, the Senate will be working on the impeachment trial, and two, the Senate will also be confirming Joe Biden's cabinet. Now, with that said, a three-week timeline, to be honest with you, is very, very optimistic. A more realistic timeline would be the middle of March. And that is because, of course, Republicans are expected to counteroffer, and these negotiations tend to take weeks, even months. And of course, that unemployment boost, the current one, ends on March 15th. So the Senate is expected to use that as a soft deadline. Again, we don't want that unemployment boost to run out. We might need time for negotiations. And the Senate is expected to go, they're set to go on vacation once again on March 26th. So when you combine the fact that the unemployment boost runs out on March 15th and that the Senate is set to go on vacation on March 26th, we do expect to have that as a soft deadline. So a realistic scenario here on bipartisan support would be about middle to late March to have the stimulus approved. Now, I know that is completely ridiculous. The American people need this help now. And that is exactly what Biden was saying in his speech, that we need to act quickly. However, it's going to take minimum 3 weeks, guys. And that is with bipartisan support. Now, Republicans are already opposing this bill, mainly because of the national debts and that $15 minimum wage that Biden included in the bill as well. Now, a lot of this is going to depend on Mitch McConnell. Can Joe Biden get Mitch McConnell on board, who would then be expected to be able to get at least a dozen or so Republicans on board as well, to get bipartisan support on this bill? Now, we're not clear on what Mitch McConnell's going to do because he does have a long history of getting deals done with Joe Biden. And although McConnell will no longer be the majority leader, he will still be the minority leader. And Of course, Republicans have a strong minority. They still have 50 votes in the Senate, and Democrats only have 51. So that slim majority still gives Mitch McConnell a lot of power. So we should have a lot of updates in the next few days as far as how Mitch McConnell and Republicans respond to Joe Biden's proposal. So don't forget to subscribe. At this point, it is expected that Democrats would need about a dozen Republicans to be on board in order to get 60 votes in the Senate. And those 60 votes are what's needed to avoid a filibuster. Now, if Republicans are not on board with this bill, Democrats will then have to move to budget reconciliation, which is expected to take about 3 months, at which point we would not get stimulus until April or even potentially early May. Now, Joe Biden does not want to go this route for two reasons. One, first of all, he wants to foster a bipartisan culture in the White House. He wants to end this divide, and he wants both Republicans and Democrats to work together to help the American people. And of course, he is willing to compromise. So we're hoping that's going to happen. Not only that, but Joe Biden wants to save that budget reconciliation loophole for a second stimulus bill. Now, that second stimulus bill would be mainly to create jobs, to create blue-collar jobs by rebuilding our infrastructure through roads, highways, and public transit, as well as white-collar jobs by investing in research and development for green, clean energy, which of course would also help save the environment, which is another of Joe Biden's number one priorities. But guys, that is the expected timeline. It's either going to take 3 weeks in an absolute best case scenario. A more realistic scenario would be March 15th or March 26th, which is about 2 months. And if that doesn't get done through bipartisan support, then Joe Biden is expected to then use budget reconciliation, which would take about 3 months, okay? So that is the expected timeline. But it's not only Republicans opposing this bill. Even some liberal Democrats are not happy with the bill. Now, AOC has come out criticizing Joe Biden, saying that these $2,000 checks need to be a full $2,000, not $1,400. And let me know in the comments if you agree. Personally, I completely 100% agree. I honestly think the American people need $2,000 per month until this pandemic is over. And let me know in the comments if you agree. So because of this, there's going to be a lot of negotiations to be had in the next few weeks. It's not only Republicans, it's some Democrats who are pushing for even more stimulus. So we should have a lot of updates in the next few weeks, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. Bernie Sanders made a comment about that budget reconciliation. He said, "When Republicans controlled the Senate, they used the budget reconciliation process to provide huge tax breaks for the rich and large corporations." He's referring to Trump's tax cuts that he passed in 2017. He went on to say that Democrats are going to use reconciliation to protect working families, the sick, and the poor. And guys, let me know in the comments if you like Bernie Sanders, whether or not you are a liberal. He has been the strongest proponent for those $2,000 stimulus checks. And he is reiterating the fact that Republicans will not block this stimulus. If they try and block it, Democrats will be using budget reconciliation. So this massive stimulus package is guaranteed, guys. We will be getting this massive stimulus package. It is just a matter of when. And again, if they can get Republicans on board, just about a dozen or so, we could have this package in the next few weeks to 2 months. Okay, let's cover a quick recap of unemployment, because I just want to point out the fact that although the unemployment rate has dropped since March and April, it is still really bad for those who are low income. Now, those who are low income still have an estimated unemployment rate of 20%. So those who are already at the lower end of the spectrum are being hit the hardest throughout this pandemic, guys. And this is why we need that unemployment boost approved quickly. And Biden's $400 per week, in my opinion, it's still not enough. I think we need that full $600 per week. And let me know in the comments if you agree. But economists say that $400 per week for the average American would replace 86% of their income. Obviously, that is a pretty good number, not 100%, which we deserve, because we lost our jobs during this crisis at no fault of our own. Guys, but let me know in the comments what you think about this stimulus package, and don't forget to subscribe. I will have updates daily on the negotiations, on those $2,000 stimulus checks, as well as the unemployment boost and stimulus for those on Social Security. Now, I quickly want to recap what to do if you still have not received your $600 stimulus check. Now, for those of you who did not receive it because you filed your taxes through H&R Block or Jackson Hewitt, now they are expected to try and reroute that to you despite the fact that the January 15th deadline has passed. So continue to check your mail, continue to check your bank accounts, but in the meantime, as soon as tax season begins, file your taxes and you'll be able to get those stimulus checks as a tax refund, okay? Now on top of that, make sure that when you file your taxes, your address is updated and your bank account is updated as well. That way, when this next $1,400 stimulus check is approved, you will receive it a lot quicker and you will not have any issues like this previous stimulus check, guys. But with that said, guys, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for supporting my channel. And if you made it this far into my video, thank you so much for supporting my channel, guys. It's been my dream to go full-time on YouTube, and I'm halfway there. I'm at about 50,000 subscribers, and if I can make it to 100,000, I'm going full-time, and I'll be here every single day making videos, helping you guys, giving you the information you need to get through this crisis. So guys, thank you so much for your support. It really means the world to me. And stay strong out there, guys. You will be in a better place. It's been a difficult year, but trust me, you will make it to a better place. And guys, with that said, thanks again for watching, and have a great day.